हेलो फ्रेंड्स, हैप्पी टू मीट यू थ्रू द लेक्चर वंस अगेन ऑन द सब्जेक्ट ऑपरेशंस रिसर्च. टुडे फॉर डिस्कशन वी टेक लेक्चर नंबर 3 ऑन मॉड्यूल 1 ग्राफिकल मेथड. सो यूजिंग द ग्राफिकल मेथड हाउ टू फाइंड द सॉल्यूशन फॉर लीनियर प्रोग्रामिंग प्रॉब्लम. We recap the previous lectures. So in the previous lecture, we discussed the formulation of the problem, where we discussed the converting the real-time problem or description of the problem into a set of mathematical equations, which involves decision variable, objective function, and constraints. So decision variables are given by the item to be sold or machine, so the parameter which influence the objective function, which will increase, which will maximize or minimize the objective function. Objective function is maybe either maximization type or minimization type. In the case of profit, it is maximization. In the case of loss or machine hour, man hour, it is minimization. Constraints are the set of equations given by the in terms of decision variables. The constraints are given by the limited resources of material or man hour, anything. So the important parameters are decision variable like x1, x2, x3, objective function expressed in terms of decision variable, constraint again expressed in terms of decision variables. So what we are going to discuss here in this lecture, so graphical solution for the problem, linear programming problem, we'll define certain terminology, feasible solution, optimal solution, and we take a few examples, and finally we'll discuss about the limitations of the graphical method. So in the graphical method of linear programming problem, the terminology, first terminology is feasible solution. So it is the values of decision variables which satisfy all the constraints simultaneously is called feasible solution. So decision variables are x1, x2. We have to find out the values of x1, x2, which will satisfy all the constraints simultaneously. That is what the feasible solution. What is feasible solution space? In the graphical method, we are going to solve the problem in the xy coordinate. So immediately you can recognize that this is applicable for a linear programming problem wherein you have only two variables like x1 and x2. So the constraints are expressed in terms of equations. So we have to plot the equation in the xy plane, and we will get a space which will satisfy all the constraints simultaneously. So in the space in the xy coordinate which satisfy all the constraints simultaneously is called as feasible solution space. So from the feasible solution space, so the feasible solution is a space which will satisfy all the constraints simultaneously. So within the feasible solution space, any point or any x1, x2 value will satisfy the constraints, all the constraints, and that will give the answer. That is the answer. But among the answers, which is the best answer, optimal answer? The value of the decision variable which optimizes the objective function is known as optimal solution of the problem. So within the space, which will optimize the value is called as optimum solution. And straight away we'll take one numerical example. So using graphical method, maximize z equal to 3x1 plus 2x2 subject to the constraints 2x1 plus 5x2 less than or equal to 9 and 4x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 9 and x1 x2 are greater than or equal to 0, non-negative condition for the constraints. So this is what the problem. You have two variables x1 and x2 and two constraints here, Very simple problem. And first step, we have to prepare this table. So the constraint equations, they are inequalities, less than or equal to, they are inequalities. So you have, I have two constraints, 2x1 plus 5x2 less than or equal to 9, 4x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 9. This we have to convert into equalities. So 2x1 plus 5x2 equal to 9, 4x1 plus 2x2 equal to 9. Now we have to find out the coordinate values for the constant equation. You take the first equation, you put x2 equal to 0, that gives 2x1 equal to 9, so x1 equal to 4.5. Now you take x1 equal to 0, 5x2 equal to 9, so x2 becomes 1.8. So for this constant equality, these are the coordinate value x1 and x2. And the second constraint, 4x1 plus 2x2 equal to 9, as usual, again you take x2 equal to 0, so x1 equal to 2.25, and x1 equal to 0, 2x2 equal to 9, so x2 equal to 4.5. So these are the x1 and x2 values for this constraint equality. Now look at the value of x1, 4.5 is the maximum value, x2, 4.5 is the maximum value. Now you have to take the graph shape. I take the x-axis, represent the x1 values, maximum is 4.5, and y-axis, it represents the x2 value and the maximum equal to 5. So the coordinate, I have taken 2 cm in the x-axis equal to 1 unit of x1. Similarly, 2 cm in the y-axis is equal to 1 unit of x2. Now, you take the first constraint, 2x1 plus 5x2 equal to 9. And the x1, x2 values are x1 equal to 4.5, x2 equal to 1.8. So, 2x1 plus 5x2. So, x1 equal to 4.5, x2 equal to 1.8. So, x1 equal to 4.5, x2 equal to 1.5. You draw the line. This line satisfies 2x1 plus 5x2 equal to 9. Now, I put the arrow downward. That indicates this line, the area below this line, we satisfy this condition, 2x1 plus 5x2 less than or equal to 9. So this is how you have to plot the constraint in the xy coordinate. The second constraint, 4x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 9. What are the values? x1 equal to 2.25, x2 equal to 4.5. So x1 equal to 2.25, x2 equal to 4.5, and this line satisfy the condition 4x1 plus 2x2 equal to 9. I put the arrowhead downward, that indicates 4x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 9. So this is area below this line satisfy the second condition, area below this line satisfy the first constraint. Now combining these two diagrams, these two constraint lines, the area OABC, it is the area which is satisfy both the constraints simultaneously, and this is called as feasible solution space. Anywhere within the area, both the constraints will be satisfied. Now I have to take the point, boundary point OABC. What are the points? You take A, O equal to 0, 0, A equal to x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 1.8, B equal to x1 equal to 1.7 and x2 equal to 1.1, x2 equal to 1.1, and you take C, x1 equal to 2.25 and x2 equal to 0. So these are the three points. There are the three points, and we have to find out the solution. So you take A value, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 1.8, and Z value. So what is Z value? 3x1 plus 2x2. So 3x1 plus 2x2, 3.6. B equal to x1 equal to 1.7, x2 equal to 1.1, 7.3. C, x1 equal to 2.25, x2 equal to 0, 6.75. So among the three solutions, which is the best answer, the optimum solution. Among the three answers, point B gives the maximum of the objective function. So the result is x1 equal to 1.7, x2 equal to 1.1, and z equal to 7.3. So this is the solution for the given problem using the graphical method. We take another example. Maximize z equal to 300x1 plus 400x2 subject to the constraint of 5x1 plus 4x2 less than or equal to 200, 3x1 plus 5x2 less than or equal to 150, 5x1 plus 4x2 greater than or equal to 100, and x1, x2 are greater than or equal to 0, non-negative condition of the constraint, additional variables. And as explained in the previous example, you take the constraint inequalities as it is and then convert into constraint equalities. Now you calculate the quadrant values. So here, when you assume x2 equal to 0, so x1 become 5, x1 become 200, x1 equal to 40. You assume x1 equal to 0, 4x2 equal to 200, x2 equal to 50. Second equation, you take x2 equal to 0, 3x1 equal to 150, x1 equal to 50. You take x1 equal to 0, 5x2 equal to 150, x2 equal to 30. The third constraint, 5x1 plus 4x2 equal to 100. You assume x2 equal to 0, 5x1 equal to 100, x1 equal to 20. You take x1 equal to 0, 4x2 equal to 100, x2 equal to 25. So there are the quadrant value for three different constraint equations. So what is the maximum value of your x1 coordinate? 50. Maximum value of x2 coordinate? 50. So you take a graph, x1 axis, x axis is mentioned for x1, again 2 cm equal to 10 unit, y axis takes the x2 coordinate, x2 parameter, and again 2 cm equal to 10 units of x2. Now you take the constraint one by one, 5x1 plus 4x2 equal to 200. So 5x1 plus 4x2 equal less than equal to 200. So x1 equal to 40, x2 equal to 50. So this is the line satisfy 5x1 plus 4x2 equal to 200. So constraint is less than or equal to 200. So below this line, the area available below this line that satisfies this condition 1. Second constraint, 3x1 plus 5x2 equal to 150. So this is the line, 3x1 plus 5x2 less than or equal to 150. Now here, x1 equal to 50, x2 equal to 30. So join these two points and this is the line satisfy 3x1 plus 5x2 equal to 150. Area below the line satisfy the condition constraint 2. And the third constraint, 5x1 plus 4x2 greater than or equal to 100. Now what is 5x1 plus 4x2 equal to 100? x1 equal to 20, x2 equal to 25. And here the condition is greater or equal to any area above the line satisfy the constraint. Now, this is the first constraint below the area. This is the second constraint below the area. This is the third constraint above the line. Now, all the three constraints are simultaneously satisfied by the area A, B, C, D, E. Now, what is A, B, C, D, E? So, A, x equal to 0, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 25, B, x1 equal to 20, x2 equal to 0, C, x1 equal to 40, x2 equal to 0, D, x1 equal to 31, x2 equal to 11.5, E, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 30. So this is the A, B, C, D, E is called as feasible solution space. So now among the five points, which point gives the maximum result? That is what our idea. Now A, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 25, the constraint equation, the objective function is z equal to 300x1 plus 400x2. So here 300x1 plus 400x2. So substituting 10,000, x1 equal to 20, x2 equal to 0, 6000. x1 equal to 40, x2 equal to 0, 12000. x1 equal to 31, x2 equal to 11.5, 13900. x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 30, 12000. So, looking just to analyze, so D point D is the maximum value. Among the five answers, the point D gives maximum of the objective function. The result is x1 equal to 31, x2 equal to 11.5 and z equal to 13900. That is the answer for the given problem. Then you take another example. Example number 3. Using the graphical method, now you have to minimize. Minimize the objective function. Minimize z equal to 6x1 plus 14x2. Subject to the constraint of 5x1 plus 4x2 greater than or equal to 0 and 3x1 plus 7x2 3x1 plus 7x2 less than or equal to 84, x1 x2 is greater than or equal to 0. Now as usual, constraint inequalities, constraint equalities and then coordinate value. So here 5x1 equal to 60, so x1 equal to 12, 4x1 equal to 60, x2 equal to 15, 3x1 equal to 84, x1 equal to 28, 7x2 equal to 84, x2 equal to 12. So these are the coordinate value. Now what is the highest value of x1? 28, highest value of x2 is 15. So x1, x-axis x1, maximum is 28. So, every centimeter is equal to 2 units of x1 and y-axis take the parameter x2, variable x2, every centimeter equal to 1 unit of x2. Now, first constraint, x1 equal to 12, x2 equal to 15. So, x1 equal to 12, x2 equal to 15. This line satisfy 5x1 plus 4x2 equal to 60. Now, anything above the area, anything greater than this value, so above the area. Then another constraint, 3x1 plus 7x2 less than or equal to 84. So, x1 equal to 28, x2 equal to 12 and this is the constraint line and the area below this. Now, simultaneously, area ABC satisfy the two constraint equation and ABC is called as feasible solution space. Now, what are the coordinate values of ABC? A, x1 equal to 3.8, x2 equal to 10.5, B, x1 equal to 28, x2 equal to 0, C, x1 equal to 12 and x2 equal to 0. Now, which gives the optimum value? So, x1 equal to 169.8, for point B, 168, for point C, it is 72. Now, among the three answers, point C give the minimum of the objective function. It is minimization type of problem. So, minimum of the objective function, x1 equal to 12, x2 equal to 0 and the minimum value of z equal to 72. That is the answer. We take the fourth example. Using the graphical method, minimize z equal to 5x1 plus 4x2. And the constraints are 3x1 plus 2x2 greater than or equal to 5, 2x1 plus 3x2 greater than or equal to 7, x1, x2 are greater than or equal to 0. So, solution, first you take the coordinate value, constraint inequalities, constraint equalities and the coordinate value. So, 3x1 equal to 5, x1 equal to 1.6, 2x2 equal to 5, x2 equal to 2.5, 2x1 equal to 7, x1 equal to 3.5, 3x2 equal to 7, x2 equal to 2.3. So, when you calculate x1 value, you assume x2 equal to 0. When you calculate x2 value, you assume x1 equal to 0. So, like that you have to calculate. Now, what is the maximum value? 3.5 for x1 and 2.5 for x2. Now, you take the value. Your x-axis, it represents x1 coordinate. Every centimeter is equal to 0.2 units of x1 coordinate. So, maximum is 3.6. Y-axis represents the x2 coordinate, every centimeter again 0.2 units of x2 and maximum point is 2.8. What is your first value? X1 equal to 1.6, X2 equal to 2.5. 1.6, X1 equal to 1.6, X2 equal to 2.5. Okay, 2.4 and 2.5. So the line represents the 3x1 plus 2x2 greater than or equal to 5. So greater than or equal to any area above this. And the second constraint, 2x1 plus 3x2 greater than or equal to 7. So your x1 equal to 3.5, x2 equal to 2.3. So 3.5, 2.3 here. So this line is satisfying the second constraint, anything above, beyond the value of the line. Now there are two constraints. This is the first constraint. This is the second constraint. The two constraints. So both the constraints are greater than or equal to the area above the line A, B, C will satisfy the two constraints simultaneously. So there is no confined space. Anything above this will satisfy the condition, will satisfy the constraints. Now A equal to 0, 2.5. B equal to 0.2, 2.2 and C equal to 3.5, 0. Now, once again, you calculate the Z equal to minimize Z equal to 5x1 plus 4x2. So, for the first A point, x1 equal to 0, x2 equal to 2.5, the answer is 10. For the point B, x1 equal to 0.2 and x2 equal to 2.2, the answer is 9.8. For the third point coordinate C, x1 equal to 3.5, x2 equal to 0, the answer is 17.5. The objective is to minimize the Z value, Z equation. So, the three answers, point B, it gives the minimum value of the objective function. Result is x1 equal to 0.2, x2 equal to 2.2 and Z equal to 9.8. So, we have discussed four problems on the graphical method, two problems on the maximization type and two problems on the minimization type. In all the problem, we identify the space, the coordinate, the corners of the feasible solution space. So, we calculated the answer for the Z value for the corners of the feasible solution space. Among the three or four values, which is the maximum or minimum, that is the answer to the problem. Now, there are certain observation in the graphical method, solution in the graphical method. We have certain comments. First type of problem, a definite and unique optimal solution. This is what we have discussed so far. Four problems, all the four problems, they have only one answer, one optimal answer, right? So, that is what discussed in the earlier problems. Sometimes, multiple optimal solution, how to identify multiple optimal solutions. I take this example. Suppose you calculate the answer, you take this graph, calculate the answer, point A, point C and point B. Substitute the values of A and B in the Z equation. A and B, if the answer Z for A and B are equal, that means the line is satisfying the condition. So, you will get multiple answers. So, you will get more than one solution. That is what multiple number of optimal solution. So, it is again a problem for graphical method. So, we have to use some other technique. For example, simplex technique to find the optimal solution. Then unbounded solution. So, listen to the diagram. So, this diagram. It is bounded, the solution, the constant equation simultaneously satisfying a bounded area. So, this is bounded solution. When the solution is not bounded, it is called as unbounded solution. In that case, there is no feasible solution space. So, you cannot get the answer. You cannot get the feasible solution space. And again, once the feasible solution space is not formed, you cannot find the optimal solution. So, sometimes, there may be infeasible solution in the graphical method when all the constraints are not satisfied or sometimes non-negative conditions are not maintained by the constraints, right? So, these are all the three. First one, we have solved definite and unique optimal solution. We have solved in the numerical example. 3, 4, 5, 2, 3, 4, these are all the special cases in the graphical method, which we will discuss, which will, with this kind of problem, we can handle with other methods, like a simplex method, Big M method, and the two-phase method in the linear programming problem. So that is the end of the graphical method. So what are the limitations? So graphical, so from the four numerical example, you may observe that graphical method is easy and simple when the decision variables are two. So when the decision variables are two, then only we can apply the graphical method. If the decision variables are more than two, we cannot use the graphical method. So in practice, there is no such operation research problem with the two variables. So practically, but it is a beginning. So at the beginning, with the two variables, you solve the problem. You understand what is the feasible solution. You understand what is the optimal solution. So later on, we'll be using the same terminology, same terminologies in the future simplex methodology, other methodology, so that it is easy. So this is the starting point. So solve the problem with the two variables, and we will go to the three variable, four variable problem in the other methods. However, it is a starting point to understand the solution procedure. So these are all the limitations of the graphical method. So finally, our life is what our thoughts make it. So what kind of thought do you have in your mind? That determines. So if you are positive, you will be a positive man. So you will be always optimistic. So you will find solution everywhere, not the problem. Right? So you find solution in every opportunity. Thank you. We'll meet again.